Hi, everybody. Let's look at these amazing graphs of the Phoenix real estate markets to see where the Phoenix real estate market is headed and where it is right now. And also, I'll show you how to look at your specific city and your specific zip code on the charts. It's been a while since I've talked about the Phoenix real estate market. I've been working a lot on my other website, my national website, realestatedakota.com. But wanted to get back to this. And then I had my 30th wedding anniversary, and then I had my birthday, and then I got this cold, which I think I'm pretty much over, but man, it started in the, ended up in my chest, but I think I'm pretty much over it and I'm ready to do this. But I'm not going to do a video of me right now, that's for sure. Okay, here's the Phoenix real estate market at a glance. This has a great single graph. I think it's the best single graph to look at the market. And you can mouse over it to get additional information, particularly if you look on the green line, I have all sorts of additional information. And the green line is the price. This is for all homes. It includes, and the green line is for condos. And it shows you the median price. The red line is the inventory. That's the number of homes. You can see it over here on the number of homes that are for sale right now. Whoop, there we go. Happens a lot. And the blue line is the number of homes that's sold. So you can look at it, and you can, by just mousing over here, you can get a good feel for what's happening in the market. You can compare it to where it was last year. For example, the median home price was a 210, which is 7.7% above what it was last year for that month, the month of January. So good. You can see this on this basis, you know, it's been pretty flat. Inventory is kind of tight. You can go down to this next graph I have, which includes this, whatever that color is, line, which is new homes. There are new listings that are hitting the market, which is a big factor. So you can see homes, these are the homes that hit the market. These are the homes that sold on the market. So these are the homes that didn't sell. The difference here is the homes that did not sell, hit the market, didn't sell. So as you can see, when the market tightens up, then more and more homes that hit the market are selling. But you can mouse over this and get a feel for example, look at the number of new listings. It's up by 3.4% compared to January last year. But go down to the next line, and the number of homes sold are up by 9.2% compared to January last year. And then you go down to the bottom part, which is month supply. That's why month supply is 4.4, where last year in January it was 5.2, because the sales are larger than the number of homes that are hitting the market. Good. And also you can look at the number of homes listed for sale are down 7.3% compared to January last year. So it's a basic conclusion of this whole video is that the market's strong, prices are strong. It's a kind of a short supply situation. Also, if you want to look at the inflation adjusted, this is nice. You can see the prices now are about where they were when prices were starting to take off in 2004. Now let's look at the other graphs. Now these graphs, my three key graphs, these are for subscribers only. These come from the Cromford Report. The Cromford Report is a subscription service for $300 a year, but it's only available to members of the local MLS. So it's only available to real estate agents. But the guy who makes it, Mike, gave me permission to show it to my clients and my prospective clients. So I have made the definition that if you subscribe to my email newsletter, you're a prospective client and I can show it to you. And I thank Mike for giving me permission to do that. Hopefully he doesn't take that permission away sometime. And so that I can't show him anymore. But right now, it's really, really great. In these three graphs, you can get a really good feel for the Phoenix real estate market and in your town. So let me show you how to use it here, or show you how I use it. First, if I want to look at this is that monthly average sales price per square foot. That previous graph of mine was the actual sold price. It's better to look at square foot price, because sometimes the market will change where a lot more of the larger homes are selling. So that kind of skews the price, but it wouldn't skew the square foot price as much. So let's look at this. I'm going to get rid of the HUD. I'm going to get rid of the REOs and short sales. There, get rid of HUD, REO, short sales. Takes a while for it to come back. And I only want to look at single family detached. I don't want to look at condos. Click those off. So you can see, just looking at a square foot basis, holy mackerel, that is a really steep momentum going into the last time. Has February, doesn't have complete February data, but yeah, with partial February data, it's looking a really strong upward market for prices. But your town might be different. Let's get rid of all of these and just look at Phoenix. Okay, this is a little slow. There we go. Phoenix. Phoenix, wow, that is an incredibly strong trend and stable trend in sales price per square foot. Let's get another. You can pick this for any city if you want. Let's get rid of Phoenix and look at Scottsdale. More expensive market. It's a little kludgy here the way you gotta select them. Something weird going on there. February is only partial. But look how steep it was from October. What the heck is going on there? So that, I don't know what's happening there, but something weird is going on in Scottsdale. It may be for all more expensive homes. So you can do that for Chandler Gilbert or wherever you want to look at it. And you can even get down to the zip code. The zip code, the numbers can be really funky because there's not that many sales, so they bounce all over the place. But nevertheless, it can be worthwhile. I definitely want to check out my own zip code, see if there's something I can glean from it. And here's the other one. This is the active listings. These are the number of homes that are actively listed for sale in the MLS. Now I'm going to get rid. Well, since it's showing here the by different colors what's HUD and what's REO and what's short sales, I'll just leave all of those in. But the dark blue down here at the bottom is the normal, the listings that are just normal sales. But I don't want to look at condos. Don't want to look at condos, don't want to look at mobile homes. And that shows you, look, there were the number of homes listed for sale February 20th are a lot less than they were last February 20th. Where are we? March. So it's, yeah, so that's one reason why the prices are so strong is that we have a little bit fewer homes for sale. That's and you can do the same thing by the city. Let's look at the different cities here. See how Phoenix is different from Scottsdale, for example. Phoenix is way down, and the number of homes that are listed for sale, that explains the prices in part. And let's go down to Scottsdale just to show you how to use the system. Oh, Scottsdale is a totally different story. See, it's higher now than it was last February. So that could be some of the, well, we saw that weirdness in the Scottsdale numbers. That could be because we're a little bit higher inventory than at that than at this time last year. So let's go look at the last graph. This combines it, to get a feel for the market. It's kind of a fight between the number of homes that are for sale and the number of homes that are selling. And the way to combine them into one number is the month supply of homes listed for sale. So this in one number gives you a feel for how tight the market is. You see right now for Metro Phoenix is 3.8, but let's get rid of condos and mobile homes. Get rid of the condos and mobiles. And we're at 3.8, which is kind of a tight supply. In my mind, 4 to 6 is normal. And when you get down to 3.8, but it's also important to see where it was at last year at this time. So it's 3.8. Now in late February, where was it last in late February last year? Let's see. It was at 4, but it was already falling. Huh. That's interesting there. Don't know exactly what to make of that. I have to study a little bit more, but let's go down. Oh, let's get rid of the short sales. And the REO on the HUD. Okay, there, that's better. Okay, that should have done that to begin with. So we're at like 4 months supply, and last year at this time it was about a little bit higher, similar, but it was already falling. Interesting. Now this one doesn't have the zip codes, but you can go through and pick different cities. So let's look at Phoenix. Hope this isn't taking too long for you, but I think it's you really want to look at your city, not just Metro Phoenix. Wow, so that's quite a bit different than it was last year. So the supply is a lot tighter. Right now it's 2.9 in Phoenix for normal sales or normally listed homes, non-distressed sales. 2.9, where was it the year before? It was, oh, it's a lot less than it was the year before at this time. Okay, next one last thing, and then we'll finish up just to see what's going on in Scottsdale, just to show you kind of how to use the system. Okay, it resets after getting ready Phoenix, and you have to go back and choose the one. Every time you choose a city, it resets again, which is a little annoying, but that's the way it is. Oh, okay, can you see there's a lot? There's 8 point. Oh, that's a lot of months supply in Scottsdale. 8.5. What was it last year at this time? 8.5. It was 7. So that could show why there's going to be 8.5 is a lot. That doesn't change much. You can see this is a time of year where there's a lot of changes going on. It's peaks and then falls. But a little bit higher than it was at this year time could put, we'll get rid of the upward pressure on prices anyway for Scottsdale. Hey, good. So I hope you enjoyed this. I hope this was able to go through and give you a feel for what's happening in the market in Phoenix right now, but also how to use those three special graphs you won't find anywhere online. You only for subscribers, and they come from the Cromford Report. Hopefully, you can really get a feel if you're a real estate geek or just a geeky person like me. You're an engineer or a numbers person. This is the way you can find out what's happening, and you'll probably know by looking at these three graphs, plus my own graph, the more than a lot of real estate agents will be able to tell you on the basics of the market in your area. Great. So I'm John Wake. I'm with Arizona Real Estate Notebook. Hope you enjoyed this, and I hope you enjoyed my new retro design for for real estate, ArizonaRealEstateNotebook.com. Take it easy, everybody. Thanks. Hey, please leave me a call. Leave a comment. Thanks, everybody. Take care.